Alrighty, well, the February 2014 Netrunner tournament at the 20Sided store in Brooklyn, New York was pushed back a week because of a Magic the Gathering event. I don't know if that was the problem or if it was the cold weather, but the turnout was rather low. We only had, I think, 9 runners show up, which is below average for us. But that's okay because there were 9 awesome runners, like the best of the best in New York, all the regulars, everyone knew each other. You know, it was going to be, you could almost consider it like the top 9, almost, of New York City. Well, I guess there were a few people missing, but yeah. Anyway, here we go. In the first round, randomly, got paired up against Chris, who I play a ton. You may have seen me play against him in the very long live stream that we did and some other videos that I've done. Probably play against him more than anyone else. We know exactly what each other are playing, pretty much. So yeah, getting the deadly opponent who knows you too well in the first round, I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. But this very first game that we played of the 3-round tournament was by far the best game of the day. Since this game was so good, I could not wait to upload it. One of the other runners wants to do commentary with me, so it's not just me alone. I'm down with that, but I realized they don't have audio mixing equipment or multiple microphones or anything. It's all at my my podcast co-host's house, apartment. Sorry, not house. We don't have houses in New York City. So, you know, maybe we'll do that for the store championship videos. Right. I guess I want to post these before they get stale, considering the Complete Strategist Store Championship is less than a week away. It is Saturday the 15th of February. Big tournament coming up. So, yeah. All right. So, I get my hand here. I'm playing Kate. It's an improved version of the Parasite Recursion Kate that I've been doing. Some guy on Board Game Geek, I forget his name, but he played it and won in a tournament, I think, in Vancouver. He made some huge modifications to it. Some of his ideas I didn't like, but some of his ideas I really did like replacing Crypsis with Atman. So I totally did that, and thanks, dude, it made the deck way better. Chris is playing NBN, which is also what I'm playing. So I'm installing my Datasucker and running. Let's fill this bad boy up. Is it Draco? Trace 4. Do I pay for that? I have a link. I can get an access. Yep, I'll do it. I'll take it because I want my Datasucker. It wouldn't be worth it normally, but it's like... All right, wall is static. Cool. I get a Datasucker token. Right, I get to see a card in HQ. It only costs 3, so if you consider removing the tag, costs 2 and a click. Right, then yeah. All right, I use my last 2 clicks to take a credit and install a daily cast. Then yeah, if removing the tag costs 2 and a click, then paying 3 to just avoid the trace altogether and save the click is a much better deal. Daily cast occurs. Gonna run R&D. Alright, so it's a Viper, big deal. Alright, so I'm gonna lose a click and end the run. Yep. So my main goal here with the running is A, get Datasucker tokens, right, for my Parasites that are gonna come busting out eventually, right? But also to make him res ice and spend money. If I can keep him below 8 credits, see he's at 5, he can't res a Sansan and score an Astro Script out of his hand. Gotta keep him below 8. So I run that remote, and he does not res. Because he does not res, I really just wanted him to res the ice. I didn't want to, right? I'm pretty sure if that was an agenda, he would have resed. Because he did not res, I'm sure it's Sansan Bernice, so I'm letting it stay there. I jacked out. If he got me with a bluff like that, good for him. Uh-oh, now he's installing something. He's installing 2 somethings and taking a credit. So Or is that his hand? Oh, I think he installed and took 2 res. Now I'm running. And now he's gonna res. Yep, that's an agenda, alright. There's that wall of static I just saw. Sweet. Or another one. Okay, made him spend money. Can't res the Sansan. Draw some cards. And what am I doing? My hand has 2 indexings in it. I'm really just aiming to index here. Alright, same old thing. Alright, I've kept him down to 4 credits. That's pretty good. He's not at 8. Oh. Must be a breaking news. It is a breaking news. Cool. And is he going to trash my daily cast, which only has 4 credits left on it? Doesn't look like it. He took a credit. Okay. He's only got 3 credits left. That's pretty nice. Got to draw through my deck, find some weaponry. I found a parasite. That's some weaponry. I could blow the Draco away. But really, I'm looking to clear off R&D for my indexing. Right? He has a Plascrete, which I know I don't need. I guess that's the problem of facing an opponent you know. It's like, I know his deck is not going to do 1 point of meat damage ever. So that Plascrete is a dead card. So I run Archives 3 times. Why did I run Archives 3 times? Well, if he clears Virus Counters, that's cool, because it means he's not drawing or taking money or getting closer to a Sansan. If he doesn't clear Virus Counters, I can install the Parasite on that Viper, indexing, go, right? Because that's just enough counters. He's fencing up the... See? By taking all those virus counters, he's thinking that Wall of Static is under threat, right? But actually, it's not the Wall of Static that's in trouble. Indexing, baby, yeah! Ding. That's the best part, is like, indexing, you use all your data suckers to clear it out, and then you get one back. Right. Okay, so notice there's a roto turret in there, right? Just notice that. Okay. Yep, run. 3 points. Oh, yes. Not any Astro scripts, though, just a Beal and a Breaking News. Okay. That's the other best thing about indexing. It's like you index. And then you make more runs to pick up the agendas you just saw, and so you basically, cost me 1 data sucker total that turn. Right? Of course, I had to spend 3 clicks to get those 3 originally from Archives. So now there's a Jackson Howard on the table, which means indexing is pretty much useless until that Jackson is gone. I keep messing that up. Pretty much constantly. That's sort of what I do. How many times have I played this game, and I remember, don't index when there's Jackson Howard on the table. But I always mess it up anyway, and eventually I do it. All right, more daily casts. Yeah, daily casts were a recent addition to this deck. I took out Maker. I had 2 Maker's Eyes and 3 Pro Contacts. I took out 2 Maker's Eyes and 1 of the Pro Contacts for 3 daily casts. Now I have way more money. In this deck, and it helps a lot because it used to be really poor. I think I'm going to take the Pro Contacts out. In fact, I've already taken them out. They had them in for this tournament. Because basically, I kept drawing it during the tournament, and I did draw many cards after that point. So if I had installed it in the long run, I would have profited with the Pro Context. But the short-term loss... See, here I go. Stupid indexing when there's a Jackson Howard on the table. He's like, no res, don't care. Because he has Jackson. He's not even going to bother. He's like, here, index. dumb as me. But luckily, I didn't actually see any agendas whatsoever. So I'm just going to rearrange his ice here. Yeah, put the pop-up window down low so he doesn't get... I don't even know what my logic is here. Put the easy to parasite ice walls on top. I don't know. Just here, take it back. Get it out of my face. There's no agendas. So I was actually sort of saved there in a way. I mean, I could have run R&D again, thus making him either res the ice or use Jackson, because he had to assume the next run was an agenda. But it was an agenda, so I'm not going to waste a click running again. But he's keeping his Jackson, which means I can't index. And I do have the same old thing on the table, so... yeah, that's just... I messed up. That's what I was saying before, right, about the pro contacts. Every time I had pro contacts during this tournament, I did not install it, because the immediate loss of 5 credits... would have basically taken down my game so much, set me back, and created a window of opportunity for the corp. Because it takes a while for you to get that money back. Daily cast, I mean, you get your money back after, like, a turn or two, right? Pro context, it could be, like, 2 or 3 turns before you're back where you started. You're not even ahead, right? So I'm going to take out the last two pro contacts, put in, I think, a Katie Jones and a sharpshooter. The sharpshooter, just because Archer's a thing. Archer's getting splashed in techie a lot, thanks to a lot of one-point agendas in there. I've even seen Archers in NBN off of Breaking News. I mean, there's just so many one-pointers and things these days. Grim is popular still, right? So having one sharpshooter, especially with SMC or Test Run, I can just bring it out. You usually don't need to run through, especially on a remote, you probably don't need to run through it too often. You know, if you recurse the sharpshooter one time, that's a lot. Okay, Grimoire. Grimoire is huge for the memory, but also that the extra virus counter when you bring out a parasite is enormous. You can clone chip a parasite at the end of the corpse turn. You'll get a virus counter. Then your turn starts, you get a second one. So that's all strength 2 ice, suddenly, just, right? And then, you know, if you're in mid-run, if you somehow bring out a parasite or test run of parasite, it gets a virus counter, right? So it's less data suckers you need. It saves you clicks, tons of clicks of extra data suckers you would have had to go and dig up. Okay. So R&D's got a massive tower now. He's got the 8 credits. He's got way more than 8 credits. Nope. He's got 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you can res Sansan and score an Astroscript, no problem. I cannot allow that to happen. Checking the internets twice, daily casting. I'm just hooked on reading the internets. I got a ton of money now. I got 2 clone chips. So I'm pretty much ready for anything. Got 6 data sucker tokens. I don't know what can stop me. I'm going to run R&D. It's an ice wall. Okay. I don't really want to wait. There's 3 ice there on R&D. I don't really want to waste my parasite on just an ice wall, right? But it's sort of the kind of the thing you have to parasite right away, because otherwise it could grow. Right, but I kind of want him to grow it. He'll spend clicks and credits advancing that ice wall. That's good news for me if he has to do that. So I kind of want it to happen. Yeah, kind of want it to happen. I think I'm gonna let the run end. Yep, let the run end. I got an SMC. Cool. Draw again, and I'll install that SMC. Yeah, that's another thing, is that the 2 memory of Grimoire is huge in terms of you can have SMCs lying around the table. Okay, so he's got the money, but I guess if he had an Astroscript in his hand, he would have scored it right now. He didn't, but Jackson is still there blocking any attempts at indexing. At the end of his turn, I'm going to SMC an Atman, right? Why do I do it at the end of his turn? To save a credit, because then on my turn, I will be able to use Kate's, so I can use Kate's ability on his turn and then use Kate's ability again on my turn, right? So that Atman only costs 2 to install, 2 for the SMC to tutor it. I'll make it strength 1 because Ice Wall. Probably should have made it strength 0 because I have all these data sucker tokens, right? That was all right. So now my turn has actually begun, right? That was the end of his turn. So Daily Cast happens after that. I couldn't have used the Daily Cast money to do that if I needed it. The other thing is that while Jackson is there blocking any attempts at indexing, and I'm not going to make that mistake. I made the mistake, but I'm not going to make it again in the same game. So yeah, I pay one to get through that ice wall. Another ice wall. Okay, I'll pay one for that one as well. No res. Okay, I'll see a card. Keep that, and I get a Datasucker. Dink. I didn't have to use any Datasuckers, so I'm down with that. And that was click one, right? Because the SMC did not cost. That was at the end of his turn. And then daily cast and then run. So I did a whole bunch of stuff at the end of his turn, beginning of mine. What shall I do now? There's no reason to run R&D. Gonna run the remote. Maybe I can get Jackson out of there. Do some indexing. Alright, he's making a strength zero, Draco. Yeah, strength zero, Draco. Right underneath my strength one, Atman. Should have made it strength zero, Atman. I have so many Datasucker tokens. Yeah, it's like, how badly do I really want to get in the remote where I know there's a Bernice, right? Is it worth it? I kind of want to just be able to trash the Sansan, because he still has 8, 9, 10, 11 credits. I guess I'm lucky here he hasn't yet drawn an Astroscript. Because if he did, it would already be in the score area. Alright, so I take the tag, and I remove it. Because I'd rather have the money right now. I have spare clicks, right? Okay, don't need the plasma. Get out of here. Green level. Oof, he's got money now. He's got money now. He advanced one of the ice walls. Yep. Saw that coming. But I'm kind of glad he spent a click and a credit advancing an ice wall. You think he was going to advance the other ice wall and decided against it. Some thinking time going on here. He does advance the other ice wall. Okay, cool. That's another click and credit that I can destroy. Yeah, so at the end of his turn, Parasite, goodbye, right? Because Grimoire, and then when my turn starts, pew, another one shows up automatically. That one's toast. Daily cast happens. Then I'm gonna. Am I gonna get the other one? I've only just started, but I can probably learn one of the priests and says, like, you come over here. It's sort of like that scene in every airplane movie. Is there anybody here that thinks that I have what in? Just hang loose. You gotta catch him. Holy shit. No, they're gonna. Yeah, Yep. Can you hit the other one? So that cost me one credit because the both parasites cost one credit because one was at the end of his turn and one was. I think I should have paid one for that data sucker and didn't. Yeah. Okay. So I should have paid one credit for that data sucker because I paid one for the parasite. I should have paid one for each. It doesn't look like I paid for the data sucker. Why do I always cheat? I also should have put a virus counter on that data sucker, right? Yeah, so you see what happened there is he basically baited me with my two clone chips into parasiting both ice walls. And my Atman was stupidly at strength 1 instead of 0. And so the roto turret shot down my Atman. So I saved one measly credit. and I guess I deserved. I'd rather have my Atman than the credit I saved. And well, there was a virus token that should be on that data sucker also. Yeah, it's sure gamble, and that's that. Okay, well, can't run R&D now. Got to draw cards until I find something. Alright, it's an SMC. Cool. Throw away a Grimoire because I already have one. I don't need that. Okay, he's drawn cards. Oh, he's clearing my virus counter. So it didn't matter that I didn't take the free virus counter on the data sucker because he cleared them, and there was no chance to use it anyway. So that had no effect on the game. I don't think my one credit really had an effect either. We'll find out. My one credit savings on that data sucker. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. He has exactly 8 credits. The Jackson is still on the table. I'm going to infiltrate that front ice. It's another ice wall. Okay. I'm going to Stimhack. So because I know that's an ice wall, right? I can Stimhack off my SMC and get, instead of getting a strength 0 Atman, I'm going to pull out the Femme, right? So the Femme is better than the Atman against Ice Wall Roto Turret because he can advance that Ice Wall all he wants. I know it's his final Ice Wall. And also the Femme takes care of those Dracos for one credit. It also takes care of future Caduceuses. It takes care of the Roto Turret, right? And it doesn't cost Data Sucker tokens, which I am starving for right now. Right? And it gets me all the way into R&D through both those ice. So, and there's my brain damage. Don't need that. Ran R&D. And I score! Character assassination. Alright. 5-2-1. Gonna run R&D again. Oh, he's got a Beel in his hand there. I guess he could just blow it through on his Sansan. Oh no, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's down to 7 credits. You know, between rezzing that roto turret and rezzing that ice wall, his money has gone down. I just need one more agenda. Well, oh, there's more ice. He's paid 2 to install it and took 2. He's still at 7. That's still not enough to Sansan and Astroscript. Checking my trash again. Drew, run R&D. All right, it's an RSVP. I'm happy to see that because I can just jack. It doesn't do anything if I just jack out, except cost him money, cost him 3 credits. He's down to 4. right? It's like, oh, RSVP? Okay, jack out, right? Even if I continue, it's like, okay, I swear, end the run. I can't spend any money. But I just drew a test run, which is the card I was looking for. So I'll spend the rest of my turn taking two credits. You'll notice I do have four data suckers, which is enough to take care. It's more than enough to take care of that RSVP with a test run parasite. Oh, but he cleared virus counters again. Well, I need my virus counters. So I'm gonna run archives. Viper. Ooh. Can't do anything about that right now. I'll lose a click and end the run. But at least I made him spend even more money. He's down to just one credit. So I'll run HQ. It's a pop-up window. Oh, I figured at one credit he wouldn't be able to res that, and I'd get in for one past the Draco. But no. So I have to give him a credit. All right, and I have to spend the second credit to get past Draco. It's a Sansan I cannot trash, but I'm getting my data suckers back, right? I guess there was a Beal in HQ at this time, unless that's it in archives. I'm going to run HQ again, get my data suckers back. I really need to be able to kill that RSVP off. I'm going to roll a die to be sure. Closed accounts. Okay, so I saw two different cards. I guess I could have won the game right there, had I known.
There's no way for me to know it either. I changed it on Thursday night after the office event. I had like
See, now even if he draws an astroship now, he's down to three credits, right? By making him even, and two of those credits are because I ran through his pop-up window twice, right? Oof, and he's gonna install even more ice on HQ. Wow, I guess he sort of has to, considering that I guess he's holding a winning agenda now, right? I should have noted that as a signal. I don't know. But yeah, as long as I keep him below 8, I mean, I could get into that remote if I really had to, right? As long as I keep him below 8 credits, and he's well below it now. He cannot Sansan an Astroscript. He has to, like, leave the Astroscript on the table or something where I can almost definitely get it. I could just test run a Parasite onto that wall of static and run. So this turn I'm just going to take money. Oh, he's finally using the Jackson, so there we go. He's putting some cards back into R&D. He hasn't even spent any clicks yet, really. He just, all he did was dump his Jackson. Finally, it's been sitting there pretty much the whole game at this point. He's installing and taking two. Okay, so now he's got the three credits. If that's an Astro, he can score it. That's bad. Also, if it's an Astro, I can run it and I can, I know I can run it and take it by test run the Parasite and run for the win. So if that's what it is, I have to run there. But I don't want to be baited. I don't want to just run there and find out, because I know there's a Bernice going to give me a tag for sure. There's a Sansan I can't trash. And that could just be like a Jackson Howard. And it's just like, I wasted a whole Parasite getting into that remote that I wanted to use on the RSVP on R&D. And I used all those running resources for a waste, right? So rather than waste a whole Parasite, a whole test run and 3 credits, it's really expensive. I'm just going to waste a click by doing same old thing, infiltration, so I can see it. Aha! It's a breaking news. Okay. So because it's a breaking news, I don't really care if he scores it, because what's he going to do to me? Close my accounts? No, because I'm just going to use all my money right now. Test run. Parasite gets one from Grimoire. Last click. Run R&D. Patoo, 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 patoo. I break, destroy the RSVP with my Datasucker tokens. I spend all remaining credits to get in. I see a card. It can't take it. But I get 2 Datasuckers, and that's that. All right, so now I've spent all my money. So if you breaking news closed accounts, it's like, okay, close my accounts. I don't even have any resources for you to trash. I use those too. Hedge fund. So now it's money time. Now it's time to worry. He's got the money back. Installs a card in the distant remote. Probably a Jackson, right? Well, we just saw it was a Jackson. But you know, that could have been something extra sneaky. You put an Astro script down there. So I took 3 credits. I ran R&D. Nothing. Just 2 more Datasucker tokens. Oh, it's a sweep. Oh, so yeah. I was worried that we might get confused and think that that token on the ice wall was an advancement and not the Femme token, which it is. So we replaced the advancement looking token with a token that was clearly belonging to me, so we knew it was a Femme token. He sweeped, but he didn't know I had 3 cards in my hand, so he only gets 2 credits. Only gets 2 credits. He forgot to ask how many cards I had. Also, that brain damage from the Stimhack is keeping my hand size down for sweep. I was getting a little hasty. I was just like, run R&D. Oh, no, wait a minute. Wait. I don't have any money. Forget that. I forgot you put a new ice there. I'm just going to take money. Oops. Got a little hasty there. Getting a little excited. I kind of wanted to make him res that ice because, you know, he's got enough credits now to score with his Sansan. See at least one agenda in that hand. Maybe 2.
Not being able to run archives all the time for data like a token is really awesome.
I will.
Okay, I'm going to you.
Sharpshooter.
Was it going to be practice or
Here it comes. Here it comes. I've tried to avoid this for the whole game. Oh, okay. He's just scoring the breaking news. Oh, is he closing my meager accounts of 3 credits? No, he's not. He did not close my meager accounts of 3 credits. But he did install another card on that Sansan. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Well, it's hard for me to get into the Parasite right now, and he knows it. How can I get in that remote? I'm going to get Berniced. So, you know, what should have tipped me off is, if he has a Sansan, why would he install an agenda face down on it? I guess it could be a character assassination, right? But anyway, I'm still going to test run the Parasite. I took a credit, I test run the Parasite. I took another credit, and I'm going to run the remote. So for the Draco, I spend 1 credit with Femme, and for the Wall of Static, I should only need to use 2 Datasuckers because 1 from Grimoire at strength 3. Oh, it was a Jackson. I got fooled. So I got fooled twice this game. I got fooled into that roto turret, and I got fooled into wasting a Parasite on a Jackson Howard that I was unable to trash. I'm tagged from Bernice because I ran on the last click. His Sansan still rezzed. And there is a Beal flying out. Nope. That tells me he does not have an Astro Script in hand. Because if he did, he would have scored that instead. Right? That would just be dumb not to. So, I know that there are 3 Astro Scripts in R&D. And I want one. So, now that I have 3 credits, I run R&D. There is a pop-up window. Oh, I don't have enough. I need 4 credits to get into R&D. Crappy crap. I won't pay 1 for the pop-up window, even though he gets 1. I'll end the run, and just take cards and credits. I'm still tagged. Big deal. What's he going to do to me? Close my tiny account. Well, that's a bad news. He's got 3 credits now. So he could score an Astro Script on his next turn. Or another Beal. All the breaking news are out. Yep, he's going to close my tiny, tiny accounts. Okay. They're closed. What should I do here? What should I do? I'll take money. Close my accounts again. Go for it.
Is 4 to 5?
If you spend a click or a credit on that, you're not scoring. Uh-oh. 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 2, 4, 5, 6. 6 to 5. Next agenda wins. Next agenda wins. There are no 1-pointers left in the deck. They're all 2-pointers. Next agenda wins. I have enough credits to run R&D. I run. Yes. Astro Script. Game over. It's a miracle. Got fooled twice. Still managed to win somehow. What a great game of Netrunner. That's what this game is all about.